Howdy, this is Randy Lisa, your Chief Memory Architect from the Getaway Travel. We are here at Maroma Beach, just a little bit south of Cancun in the Riviera Maya. And we're going to do something a little different this week. We're going to talk about sargassum. Sargassum is the seaweed that everybody is so concerned about that's rolling up on a lot of the tourist beaches, not only in Mexico, but in Jamaica, in the Dominican, in Puerto Rico, Florida. It's wreaking havoc in Florida. It's even wreaking havoc on the East Coast.
Yeah, you never know where it's going to be.
So we want to kind of enlighten you a little bit. We've done a little bit of research and know a little bit more than what we knew before we're going to shoot this video. So stay with us and we'll get you going. This is kind of what we're talking about. This is sargassum. Sargassum, not sarcasm, sargassum. There we go. Anyhow, it's a, believe it or not, they call it an algae. They don't call it a seaweed because it doesn't grow on the bottom of the ocean. It actually grows on top.
And it's very weird.
Yeah, and it regenerates. And so they call it an algae, and you can't really tell right here.
As you can see, this is sargassum. This is what Randy's been talking about. This is a seaweed that grows.
No, not a seaweed.
Oh yeah, seaweed.
They consider it an algae. And it's an algae because it grows on top of the water. It doesn't grow in the seabed.
Okay, he's done a lot of research and he knows all about this crazy stuff.
And it actually, if you look at it real closely, it's got like little berries on it that are kind of a whitish brown color.
Yeah.
And that's what gives it its buoyancy. But this is the culprit that's messing up and dirtying the beaches. This is what's dirtying up the canals in Florida. This is what's causing all the issues.
All right, so when did sargassum come about? I mean, how long has it been around?
Well, it's documented since the 15th century.
Wow.
But there's a hypothesis out there that it was long, long, long before that.
Wow, that's crazy. I think everybody thinks that it just started.
Yeah, because that's what it's just become a problem.
Oh.
And then the problem is that it's washing up and cluttering up the beaches, which is not beautiful. It's in Florida, for instance, it's getting in the canals and causing issues in the canals. The Everglades, everything. It's
so,
just wreaking
havoc.
So
why don't they just clean it all up out in the water before it gets here?
Well, because it's very, very important to the ecology. What they have found is this is a floating mat.
Okay. Well, like where is it? Where does it start?
Okay, they've named it the Sargasso Sea.
It's like a sea.
Well, It's weird. It's weird.
Okay.
Because it is the only named sea that has no land boundaries.
Wow.
The boundaries for the Sargasso Sea are actually currents in the water.
Okay.
There's a southern current, there's a northern current, there's an eastern current, and there's a western current.
Wow, okay.
And it keeps it all intact to where it is.
Where is it?
But unfortunately, it's growing. And where it is, it's in the northern Atlantic Ocean.
Okay. All right.
Okay, so the Atlantic Ocean.
So does it take up like just a tiny bit of the ocean?
No. Let's start big and work down to what it is.
Okay,
the Atlantic Ocean itself covers 20% of the Earth.
Wow, I didn't know that. That's crazy.
Okay, it's like 310,180,000 square miles.
Yeah, wow.
Okay, now let's break down the Atlantic Ocean because you have the Northern Atlantic, the Mid-Atlantic, and the Southern Atlantic.
Right.
Okay. Well, the Sargasso Sea is in the Northern Atlantic.
Okay. Yeah.
And the Northern Atlantic is 60% of the entire Atlantic Ocean.
Wow.
Yeah, okay. It's huge.
Yeah.
All right, so now if breaking down that Northern Atlantic, mm-hmm. within the Northern Atlantic is what they call the Sargasso Sea.
Okay. All right. And so there's just this big mass huge, mongous mass of stuff just floating out there in the North Atlantic?
Correct. Wow. And it's a mat of this algae, and it covers about 12 million square miles.
Wow.
The Bermuda Triangle that everybody knows so much about is located in the Sargassum Sea. So, yes. So it's huge.
Well, is there anything they can do about the abundance of the seaweed coming into this area?
Well, first off, it's not seaweed.
I knew.
Yep, it's algae.
Okay, everybody calls it seaweed, and I've got it in my mind, and I just can't get it out.
Yeah, so, it's an algae. It grows on top water, not in the seabed.
Can anyone do anything about this algae that seems to be taking over the beaches here?
Well, you know, that's funny you ask that, because back in 2014, five countries, United States being one of them, they formed an alliance and created a protective protective mandate or protective order to protect the Sargassum Sea.
Oh, wow.
And the reason being is there's so much marine life in it, and there's even new types of marine life being discovered.
Yeah, I think you said something about a type of eel.
Well, there's an endangered species of eel that is growing in the Sargassum Sea, and so it's becoming to where it's propagating, and so it's getting more abundant, so hopefully maybe it won't be on the endangered species any longer. But there's just so much of this stuff washing up.
Well, you know what? I've heard that Charisma and some other hotels, and I think just in general, this area, that they do something with this sargassum.
Well, from what I've been
told, once they break it up and get it out of here.
What I've been told is there's multiple purposes for it. And one of the things they're doing is they're drying it out, pulverizing it, and converting it into compost.
Wow.
I've also heard that they're actually creating paper out of it.
That's cool.
Rumor, I don't know if this is true or not, but I've been told that they're actually using it and compressing it and turning it into soles for sandals.
Soles for sandals?
Yeah.
Wow.
You know, kind of like hemp. But, you know, I don't know if that was true. That's just something that I've heard.
Yeah.
But, you know, this stuff, there's so much of it. So surely there's a purpose that people can find for it.
Yeah. Yeah. You know what? Where there's lemons, you make lemonade, right?
That's right.
And so, you know, I just want to ask another question. You know, there's a lot of hotels that we've seen, or resorts in the area that we've seen. I mean, like the little boutique hotels in Tulum, for instance. They don't have the manpower, the dollars, to be able to attack this problem. So it seems to really be prevalent at times. You know, it's here sometimes, and sometimes it's not, on the Tulum Beach.
Well, but that's all based on the currents.
Okay.
Okay, because keep in mind, this is the only sea that has no land borders. The borders that of the Sargassum Sea is currents. Northern current, Western current, Eastern current, Southern current, and it's the currents. And so when that current changes slightly, it redirects the seaweed the algae to go in a different direction.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
So, you know, we've been here times, you know, we come often. We've been here when the beaches were just pristine and there was very little, if any, of this algae.
Right.
But then we've been here where it was just like mountains that they were working to pull it away. But there's some resorts that do way more than others. And I think the El Dorados are probably one of the best hotel chains that work super hard to keep their beaches clean.
They do. They do an amazing job, and they have staff that comes out every morning, bright and early, with tractors, with backhoes, with, you know, front end loaders.
With wheelbarrows. Yeah.
And they are cleaning like crazy. And that's one thing that's very, very important for you guys to reach out to your travel agent, because if it's a good travel agent and they've been there, they're going to direct you to where the least amount of seaweed is to make sure that you have the true beach vacation that you are dreaming about.
Right, right. So anyway, I mean, you won't always get perfect beaches like this, but you can just count on the fact that there are some resort companies that are doing a really good job of, you know, doing their best to take care of their beaches and their shoreline for you. And then there's some others that maybe not do so well. So we know that. So definitely call us. One thing I want to say also is we do a lot of these videos on different topics and on the resorts that we support. And if we support a resort, that means we've been there, we've slept there, we know how they protect their and take care of their beaches. We know how they treat their clients. And if there's a video on it, that means that it's got a thumbs up from us.
So do one thing for us. Subscribe to our channel. Share it to at least 5 friends.
Yes,
that's all we ask,
exactly.
5 friends. And maybe on the bottom of here, drop us a little comment and let us know if there's a topic you're interested in.
Right.
Then
yeah.
We can cover that topic and let you know.
Yeah, because we really love doing these videos and bringing information to you. And we hope you love them too. So again, follow us.
Absolutely. Can't wait to design your next
dream
vacation getaway.